Hello everyone, Matt here. MCreator 2020.4 is just around the corner, and here are some of the most anticipated features coming in this update. Biomes and Entities now have improved per-element previews in the Workspace overview, so that searching for them is now much easier. You can now also select List View to see even more mod elements at once. Biomes now have better mob spawning settings, with more parameters and better overview over all the mobs spawning in the biome. Blocks can now have item-like textures in the inventory and hand. This is done by setting this texture in the top right corner. You can now create custom enchantments in MCreator. For example, to create an enchantment that harvests 3x3 area or more depending on the enchantment level, I first need to create a basic enchantment. I'll name it Super Mining and tweak some of its settings. Now create a procedure with global block breaking trigger and copy this procedure inside your procedure editor. You should also be able to find it in the procedure library to simplify the process. Now open Minecraft, enchant pickaxes and cause some mayhem. If you don't want to break the full area, you can simply sneak and mine single blocks if you want to. The remote workspace feature now supports Git branches. You can create new branches from the interface and rebase your current workspace to different branches. You can use durability of custom items instead of consuming them in custom recipes. To do this, create an item, set its durability, and tick the stay in crafting grid and damage instead of use on crafting boxes. Create a new recipe with your item, and there you go, we just made ourselves a philosopher's stone. Portals now support creation and teleportation conditions. For example, we can create a desert-like dimension that has a portal that only ignites when we are in survival and also allows you to travel through it only when those conditions are met. Now let's test this real quick. Portals are now also super fast and support teleportation for all entities. You can create blocks that support forge energy. First create a block. Enable Tile Entity, go to Energy and Fluid Storage tab, and enable Energy Storage. I'll leave other settings at their default values. Now in the Update Tick trigger, we create a procedure that will output energy to the blocks on the top of this one. We can use the procedure provided in the template library called Push 100 Energy to the block above, and replace the local variable with a new one to make it functional. We can now test it with the Power mod to make sure it works. Entities now support inventories. You first create a GUI with slots, then bind it to the desired entity and you're done. Now you can right-click the entity in-game to open its inventory. Plants now support grass-like generation. With it, you can make foliage that much more dense and diverse. There are now more visual previews on lists. For example, when choosing the advancement parent, you can see the same previews as in the workspace view. Similarly, you can also see previews when selecting entity or armor textures to make it easier to find the desired one. Procedures can now return values. Note that when the return is called, the procedure execution ends. Return values can be useful when a procedure is used as a condition. In that case, it has to return logic value. Furthermore, stacking procedures one in another is now easier than ever. Using the call procedure and get its return value procedure block, procedures can also pass values back to the procedure that called it. Multiple new procedure blocks have been added, including get nearest entity, convert item entity to item stack, place portal for a dimension if properly shaped, is entity tamed and is entity tamed by, many procedure blocks for fluid tank and energy storage management, and entity inventory management procedures, and many, many more. As well as procedure blocks, numerous new global procedure triggers have been added. Some of them are when an entity jumps, before entity hurt, entity tamed, etc. Door and fence gate block bases have been added. Blocks can now have emissive rendering, much like the magma block has. The brighter the texture, the more light it emits. This can allow for some crazy looking effects. In the variables tab, you can now define player lifetime and player persistent variables. The first one will reset to the initial value every time the player dies, while the second one will be saved forever. Last but not least, Mob AI now supports start and continue conditions. With start conditions, you can, for example, make mobs only aggressive in the rain, while with the continue conditions, you can, for example, make mobs stop attacking targets that it's currently attacking when it's daytime. These were some of the most notable features added in the upcoming MCreator release. Videos like these take a lot of time to make, so a sub to the channel would mean a lot. If you don't want to miss the latest MCreator related news and tutorials, turn on the notifications, like for more content like this, and comment with suggestions down below. Have a nice day and happy modding!